चैप्टर 13 क्षेत्र क्षेत्र ज्ञाविभाग योगा नेचर क्रीचर एंड कॉन्शियसनेस अर्जुन विजन्ड लॉर्ड्स यूनिवर्सल मेगा फॉर्म विद द डिवाइन साइट ब्लेस्ड टू हिम बट अपॉन रिटर्निंग टू द फिजिकल लेवल क्यूरियोसिटीज अगेन सीज्ड हिम ही आस्क्ड द लॉर्ड ओ कृष्णा What is the difference between the nature and creature, body and the master of the body, and between knowledge and worth knowing? Krishna said to Arjun, O son of Kunti, nature is the spirit of all physical causes and consequences. Creature is the main cause of various joys and miseries. The body and the senses of a creature is due to nature. The nature has three basic instincts, namely sattvic, rajasic and tamasic, to use the body for. The tendencies created in a body shape the creature's behavior and actions, which determine its class and next lives. The creature's body keeps getting new forms of lives according to the karma. Body and master. Krishna explained the difference between the body and master by saying, O Parth, a creature's physical reality is the body, and one who knows it is the master. The body is like a field, the field of action for the soul of the creature. A bound soul is one that is involved in physical nature of the mundane world. It constantly endeavors to gain control of the tendencies of the physical nature. For the same purpose, it acquires the field of action, that is, the body. Now, what is the body or field of action? It is a sum total of various organs. A bound soul tries ever to satisfy the demands of the sensory organs. The man who considers the body to be his real self, he can be called as the master in a mistaken way. The real master is the soul, the fragment of soul supreme. The soul does not perish, but the body does. The true master knows that physical bodies are merely fields of action, and they keep changing in the way of new life forms. What is Janan? Krishna further spoke, O Bharatline Arjun, I am the master of all the bodies. One who knows the truth of a body and its soul is the true knower. It only means that the true knowledge is knowing the relationship of the body and the soul. Being the soul of all the creatures, I am the knower supreme. In every body, I am present as its soul, the fragment of soul supreme. But I am not aligned with it. I have independent reality. I am the knower of every body. Thus, I have the highest position. As God element, I am the deity supreme of every body or all the bodies. I am the regulator of the senses of a body. Arjun asked, O Keshav, what is action field? How is it made? And why is it ever changing? From where it comes into existence? Who is its knower and how does he affect it?
Krishna revealed, O Parth, how the body is made and why it is constantly in changing process. Hear about it carefully.
Body and consciousness. Krishna said, in the making of a body, 24 elements come into the use. First of all, 5 primary ingredients in the form of earth, water, agni, air and space shape the body. Then ego, brain and instincts of sat, raj and tam are added in unmanifest form. After that, 5 sensory organs, eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin get formed. And 5 karma initiators, namely voice, legs, hands, anus and sex organs, become part of it. Then the mind comes into existence to act as the operator of outer organs. It is also known as inner organ. The organs have 5 subjects: smell, taste, vision, touch and sound. Thus, 24 elements make up a body. Desires, animosity, joys, sorrows, etc. are products of internal reactions or byproducts. The expression of the 5 primary ingredients of the body. Consciousness and instincts give expressions of behavior of a creature through mind, ego and thought, which in other words, outlines of the character. Janan and Bhakti. Speaking on the Janan and Bhakti, Krishna said, O Arjun, the Janan or knowledge includes humility, egolessness, non-violence, tolerance, simplicity, proximity to noble teachers, piety, gravity, stability, self-discipline, sensory control, correct attitude to life or death or old age and illnesses, detachment, freedom from desires for objects or persons, equanimity in situations and feelings, devotion to me, meditation, solitude, dislike for crowds, acceptance of the importance of spiritual realities, seeking the ultimate truth in philosophical way and being a believer. All the rest is ignorance. Arjun asked, Lord, how can one be devoted to you? Krishna replied, all the processes of the knowledge finally lead into devotion to me. One who is truly devoted to me, the various aspects of the knowledge get naturally initiated in him. To know me, know your soul truth. For this devotion is the most practical way. Faith is immortal and eternal. You must have the sentiment of total surrender to me.
What is worth knowing? Krishna further spoke, O Parth, you may be anxious to know what is worth knowing. After knowing this, you will be gaining the divine joy accruing from the ever being in touch of the ultimate truth, because truth of soul is eternal and infinite. It is a fragment of me under my control. It is beyond the causes and effects of the mundane world. It pervades everything. God has determined it to be the basic source of all senses. Still, it is not a part of the senses or sensory organs. It is the provider of all creatures, yet not attached to them. It is beyond the properties of nature, but it is the master of all the natural properties. Soul Supreme is present uniformly in all creatures, in spite of being fragmented in individual souls. It gives birth to creatures, fosters, and then destroys them. It is present visibly and also invisibly. It is knowledge itself and also worth knowing, and the goal of knowledge as well. It is in every heart. It lives in a body, yet is not attached to it. O son of Bharat dynasty, just as a single sun lights up the world, similarly, the soul lights up the body with light of consciousness. Those noble ones who know this truth, they gain union with eternal and immortal God element.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.